Hello.
Was started by Adri and Lydia, who they're a couple that are there in Hamilton right now. Out of Detour Cafe, so at the back of Detour Cafe, they started baking bread, and they're both super talented. The bread that they bake is beautiful. Obviously, you guys can see it inside. I just started there, and from there it evolved, and we finally acquired a space in Hamilton. So there's a commissary space in Hamilton where we do all of our baking and bread. They're now operating out of there, which is awesome because it allows us to have increased our volumes, where we can produce so much more bread now, obviously. Toronto, this is our first standalone shop, so outside of the commissary. And we have a pretty large e-com platform as well, which is where we started first. So we first started selling bread by bread subscriptions. And yeah, we find ourselves here. So we're super excited to kind of tackle the retail front. I really love all bread. But if I was going to choose one, it would definitely be the porridge loaf. It is super nutty in flavor. It's very texture driven for me. Black rice, buckwheat, rye, the whole groats are in there. So it's quite textured. It's amazing. Finished with oats on the outside, so it's really hearty. I love toasting it with a little bit of butter, a little bit of jam. I would say that's definitely my favorite one. And what got me into the bread business? Long story, I didn't think I was going to explore culinary at all. For me, it was always just something I did as a kid, like Italian family, food was very centric, so like we were always eating and never ever considered it or thought it should have been a profession, but it kind of unfolded that way for me, and I'm happy about that. So I started as a chef, and about 6 years ago, I went into bakery retail, and now I find myself at this bakery, which is amazing just because I love the values and I love the bread. Yeah, I love making people happy, so. I would think the biggest challenge, specifically I think for bakeries, is that there's been this culture developed to like fear gluten, fear carbs, fear bread. So I think kind of re-educating people to let them know that it's not so much fearing wheat or gluten, it's more so fearing the processes in which certain breads are created and fearing the, I guess, lack of good ingredients that other bread is made with, and just bringing them back to just artisanal old school bread, what is meant to be very good for you. So I think the re-education of people and having them not be afraid of it is definitely the biggest challenge. Do you guys like bread?
Yeah, we love bread. We're excited to try some.
I think bread is very unifying as well, right? Because like it's in everybody's culture, like especially Toronto. How diverse is Toronto? I think bread is probably the most common thing in everyone's home or culture. It's like everybody consumes some form of bread. So I think that's kind of cool too.
It's very much like a family thing.
Absolutely.
Like having dinner with your family.
Absolutely.
Butter.
Absolutely. And it's the most accessible food, especially in a world of like things, you know, food becoming more and more expensive. Like you can always afford bread, and it also feeds so many more than something else would.
Cool.
Awesome, guys. At Deer Grain Bakery, and we're taking a little taste test of some of the stuff we got today. So what's this right here?
So this right here is the tasty brioche. Mm. It's delicious, the bread.
There's an egg on top.
Mm. And with some ham.
That's so good.
This is the ham, some brioche.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have an almond latte.
And I think I have
the same. There's pink cups. I really like the pink cups. They add a little detail to it. Yeah. And I think that's, same one, almond latte. And they put the little latte art on latte top. Art.
You'll see that later. I don't even like coffee, but this is good. Like, this is, I don't like coffee,
that's
but
good.
This is
that's good.
Like, this is really good.
You're slowly acquiring the taste.
Slowly. Slowly, sure.
Oh my, this is so good. I love that the egg is like...
The cheese. Oh my god, the cheese is so good.
And then this is ham. What?
Mm-hmm. They're so kind. They also gave us 2 loaves of bread.
This is a classic country loaf.
This is a classic country loaf.
Oh, this is the multi-grain porridge loaf.
Yeah, very... Very nice.
It looks so good. I'm so excited to try these when we get back. Mm-hmm.
My mom's gonna love this.
And then this one.
This is a brown sugar glazed muffin. Mm-hmm. Definitely sugar glazed.
Taste test?
Mm-hmm. Oh, this is good. Mm-hmm. It's not apple cinnamon, but it is apple cinnamon. I'll call the apple.
Apple cinnamon without the apple.
Mm-hmm. So I'm saying it's like apple cinnamon without the cinnamon. I mean,
without the apple.
Yeah.
That's so. This reminds me of like this TikToker. She makes like, what's it called? Food videos.
For my first birthday, like, this is very nice. It's very chic, nice inside. Like, the bread's displayed, it's very nice, like everything's like in display. You can see the quality of bread like up front before buying it. Mm-hmm. So you know what you're buying is like actually quality. I started enjoy too.
And it's just like, it's simple, like the way that she spoke about,
yeah,
how lots of people say bread is like unhealthy for you, but she said it's like the practice of it and the ingredients that you use,
the rise of the prices for food, so that people have to like use cheaper options, so the quality goes down. But like, mm-hmm, you really taste like when people like use good quality food and good quality,
yeah, like, that bread. Stuff.
Exactly, like you see like the stringiness from it, like, mm-hmm, the gluten's like still activated, you know. Mm-hmm. That's nice.
Good.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Really good. Right.
Amazing. Yeah.
I know, it looks very good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Mm. Thank you.
Yeah, so Dear Grain is just on 48 Queen and Ossington Street. It's such a nice area to walk around, especially on a Saturday morning.
Mm. It's very nice. Mm. People usually walk their dogs. There's a good amount of people. And the street's just very nice. A lot of like nice stores.
Lots families of families always walking their dogs, pushing their kids in strollers. Speaking of dogs.
Oh.